G'day guys, how's it going? Welcome to the vlog. In this episode, we're going to do a cash game, Adelaide Casino. This was actually the game which was in between my two vlogs back when I did the vlog about having a bit of a downswing. So I did two there where I lost. This was actually in between where I had a bit of a win. So a couple of good hands there. I think I've got about five or six hand reviews, so we'll go through those. What I did do with this episode is it's always hard to remember what your hands are, and I don't know how Andrew and them do it. I know they write it down or they put it in their phone, but they tend to be able to have a lot better memories than what I got. But I found the little recording app on the phone, so what I'd do if I had an interesting hand, I'd just get up and go to the corner and talk into my little recording machine. And I could go back and record exactly what happened with the hand. So pretty dumb. I should have done that ages ago. So few nice hand reviews here. At the end of it, we might go out to the family farm where they're seeding at the moment, coming into winter. So they're putting the crops in, wheat and barley, things like that. So fairly big setup out there. That's where my son works. Probably, I think they're putting in about 8,000 acres this year. So a fair bit of cropping they're doing. So I think I might shoot out there with the drone and try and get a little bit. After this vlog, I've been a bit slack. I've had a lot of shit happening, so pretty hard to keep up with them. I'm still about three or four sessions behind. So plan is next vlog, I'm just going to call it a catch-up vlog where I'm going to go through very quickly those sessions, how I went, and that'll get me back on track, and hopefully I can keep up for a little while then. So hope you enjoy it. Leave some comments and stuff if you've got any questions about the hands or if I played them wrong. And we'll catch you guys next time.
Standing in the corner like a tired boxer, one hand on my cheekbone, one hand on the rope. And all my veins pump blood into my throat so I can hit the note, go do it all again, tell them all I said hi. Tell them all I said hi. And I lay half awake thinking what's it gonna take for my moment to arrive, so sick and paralyzed. And I chew my gum on the left side of my mouth, wonder when I'll spit it out. Yeah, I'm just getting started. Till I'm all I said hi. Hope you've been well.
Time update here. Going alright, about 300 up. It's about 1 o'clock in the morning. Got one bloke in there, a bit crazy. Looks like he's a bit of a recreational player, but he's given good value. So I've got him a couple of times, we've seen him in the hand reviews. So I'm just going to hang in until he goes. We'll see how we go. Catch you later.
Come on, hurry
up. Alright, go.
Go.
G'day guys, how's it going? So we've just finished up. What's that in my eye? I must be tired. Looks like I've got a bloody black eye there. Put it on my good side. And yeah, end up being not a bad night. stayed with that guy that I wanted to do, that stayed, the New Zealand guy. Knew what he was doing a bit, but a bit crazy. So I was going to stay as long as he was there, but my stack started whittling down. Then I got caught in another pot with a guy, and I probably shouldn't have played it. It was an ace, played ace three, and just played it shit. And then he put me all in, and I didn't call in the end with two pair. So would have put me back to 300 down, and so we had to re-stack in again. But I think I did the right thing. I shouldn't have played the end to start off with. But yeah, kept hanging in there. So I got back to even after being over 300 up. And then I started getting the guy I was after. I got him two or three times. So they'll all be in the hand reviews. So in for 300, out for 827. So a nice little profit there of 527. And there they are, about to go and cash them in. So ended up being a good night. So some good hand reviews. I did learn one thing tonight. I'm hopeless remembering all the hands, so I should have done it ages ago. Got this little app, like a recording app. And so every time after my big blind had finished, every time after my button had finished, I'd go in the corner and say what hands I had. So we'll see if it worked. I'm not too sure, I haven't run them back yet, so I bloody hope it worked. So yeah, good way of remembering the hands. So probably going to be five or six this time, so a few more hand reviews, because I'll be able to bloody remember them. But yeah, good night. Heading back to the van now. We might go for a bit of a cruise through Ironley Street, see what's happening. Might get something to eat, not too sure. But yeah, good night overall, and should be home in about an hour and a half. It's about 3:30, they just called last three. I usually hate playing last three, so I pulled out before them. Everyone starts going crazy, because if you're new to the vlog, casino poker room only opens at 7 at night, and it finishes at 3:30 in the morning. That's when they call last three hands. So yeah, I got out. So nice night, catch you guys later. G'day guys, how's it going? Let's get these hand reviews going here. Got a few here in this episode. So in this hand, I'm in the cutoff position and sat in seat six all night. Got a little bit of an interesting one here with the guy in middle position, seat four. He was an American guy, and got dealt the kings. It checks around to me. I end up raising it up to $80, or flat called around to me. I end up getting another three callers with the raise. Flop comes fairly handy. We get a king on there, so we got the set. So it's looking good. It checks back around to me, so everything's pretty basic at the moment. I put in about a 35. I think that's about the right size with these other three runners. Probably could have been a little bit more. They still hang in there. And they all stayed for the call. So maybe my bet size might have been a bit small. Got a bit interesting here on the turn. I didn't put it in the app because I forgot to do it. And I wasn't going to go back and redo it. But the American guy in seat four all of a sudden goes to donk bet, and he does a string bet where it looks like he was going to put out about $50 bet, and he accidentally dropped three chips. And very strict at the Adelaide Casino with string bets, so they only allowed the 15, so it doesn't show on here. I end up raising him then up to 55, I think it was. So, yeah, checks around to me. This is where he did the donk bet, but I haven't got it in there. I raise it to 52. I still get two callers, including the American guy, hoping he was going to raise again, but he didn't. So I think he was just having a bit of a stab there. Eight comes. All of a sudden, the big blind goes straight in and bets 45. I put a raise in because the American guy called too. I'm thinking I want to get it down to one player. And obviously, in the end, I was a bit worried about the straight, but me trip kings got there. So with this next hand, I run into this New Zealand guy on seat one. I'm on the button, and this bloke, he's been sitting there for probably about three quarters of an hour, full of action, just going fairly crazy, doing big bets, and but knew what he was doing. But he had mates on the rail watching him, and a couple of other mates. So I think they're on holidays in New Zealand. I got on pretty well with him. We were having a few jokes together, and but he used to be a sheep shearer or something over in New Zealand. So pretty tough old bloke, and did know a little bit about playing poker, but was playing very loose. So in this hand, I'm on the button. I end up getting ace king. So it checks around to me. I put a bet in of $22. We get a big blind call, and the New Zealand guy comes along for the ride too. Flop's pretty handy for me. I get the king, so I'm going to obviously keep betting here. It checks back to me, and I put in a bet of $35. Big blind folds, and it's just me and the New Zealander guy. He just calls. He's obviously hadn't got too much at this stage. But the six comes, it's looking a little bit, could have a straight or something there, but I go ahead and bet 45, he calls, and it's getting a little bit worse there, but I probably should have bet here. He checks. I decided to check just in case he'd jam two pair or something like that. As it was, I ended up winning, but probably should have bet on that last card for a value bet. So next hand, why do I say so all the time? Let's start this again. This next hand, I run into my New Zealand mate again. I'm under the gun there. I get dealt a pair of kings, and he's around in the low jack position. I bet 22, he called, and there was one other caller in middle position. And flop, nothing special there, but I still think I'm leading here by a fair bit. So I bet 35, that gets rid of the middle player. New Zealand guy comes along for the ride again. Nothing much happening here. I think that three's pretty card dead. So I bet 55, he calls again. I'm a little bit worried, but I've had a good run against him up until here. Two comes, I decide to put a value bet in here of $40. He ends up calling, and he saw my kings and mucks them. So nice little pot there. This next hand, I'm in the cutoff position, and I got this guy to my left who works at the Matchroom Poker Room in Adelaide. I think he might even be part owner of it. But it's just a poker room that just has tournaments through the week, four or five nights a week. And I've played this guy a few times before, and he just tends to always walk over me for some reason. So in this hand, I also think I played it pretty shit out. So as the hand went, I end up getting ace three suited. It folds all the way around to me, and that's probably when I should have put in the raise, but I didn't, so I think I played it wrong there. The guy to me left it, put the raise in. I end up calling, so there's just the two of us. I get the ace in the flop, but I got a shit kicker, but I think I'm going to stay in for the ride here. As I said, this guy tries to walk over me all the time, so I called my 38. Turn, not much help for anyone, but I check it. This time he bets 65. I have a bit of a thing and said, no, I'm not going to let him walk over me, so I end up calling. The river comes fairly handy for me. I decided to put a donk bet in. I thought we'll try and slow him down a bit here. So I end up putting a bet in of $75. That didn't seem to help too much. He all of a sudden came right over the top of me with $200. I did go into the tank, as you can see on the screen. I ended up folding it. I went into the tank and I was very close to calling. And then I just thought, there's a fair chance he must have something here, so probably a shit fold, not too sure, but I did hear him talking to his mate after he was sitting the other side of him, saying that he had trips beat, so I'm pretty sure he must have had a straight in there, so unless he was just bullshitting because he knew I was listening, so not too sure. I think I played it completely wrong. Ended up folding, so yeah, not the best hand there that I've ever played. So with this next hand, I run into my New Zealand mate again. He's on the button and I'm in middle position. I get dealt a nice hand of ace queen suited, so I put in the raise of $17. End up getting three other callers, so there's four of us in the pot, including my New Zealand mate. Flops pretty handy, but it's a fairly wet board. I get flop two pair, but not over happy with it. But I decided to do, obviously, the continuation bet here. And I do a bet of $45. Middle player after me still calls, so does the New Zealand guy, but we get rid of one. Still not looking real good with that nine, but I'm not worried about the New Zealand guy really, so I put in another bet. I'm glad when I see the next player fold and it's just me and the New Zealand guy. Obviously he needs 10 jack for the straight there, and I'm sure he would have bet by now, so I put in a bet of 65. All of a sudden he raises to 148, and I did go in the tank for a touch, but seeing it was that guy, I pretty well called straight away, and end up taking down the pot. He had two pair, but kings and eights. With this last one, I get to run into my New Zealand mate one more time. I'm on the big blind this time. It flat calls back around to me. The small blind checks it, and I decide to check it. Probably with it flat calling around to me, maybe a raise should have, I probably should have raised it, but I didn't. So we just checked to get to see a flop. End up getting a top pair, so I decide to put out a bet once it checks to me, and bet 35. My New Zealand mate, he comes in and everyone else folds. So it's just me and my New Zealand mate again. On the turn, I get the best card I can, another 10. So this time I decide to check it. So I'm hoping he's going to come in, but he doesn't. So last card comes up. So this time I put in an over bet. I go a bit bigger than what I probably should have, and I bet 85, trying to get him to call, which he ends up calling. And I end up taking it down. So yeah, I think that over bet helped a little bit then. So nice hand to finish it off with him.
I stand in the corner like a tired boxer, one hand on my cheekbone, one hand on the rope, and all my veins pump blood into my throat so I can hit the note, go do it all again, tell them all I said hi. I said hi. And I lay half awake thinking what's it gonna take for my moment to arrive, so sick and paralyzed. And I chew my gum on the left side of my mouth, wonder when I'll spit it out. Yeah, I'm just getting started. Tell them all I said hi.